Hello everyone, this will be the review of game Lizer and the keywords provided by developer. This is a very small game based on refracting a laser beam. The puzzle, because it's a puzzle game, becomes more and more complex. There is, I guess, 36 levels from what they say. I did around half of the game in 15 minutes, so it's definitely not a very long game. But the complexity is growing from level to level. For this sort of game, a logical puzzle game, this isn't much. 36 mostly short levels, like half of them are very short, probably like 30 seconds to finish on the average. That's not much. Also, the game has very limited controls and settings. You cannot choose a level, you have to go one by one, and you have only one button. I should be able to show you now. Only one button for sound, right? So this is all you can do. You can switch on and off sound, and you have music or you don't have music. This is the button for full screen, and this is probably quit. I didn't quit it. I just started the game, went through. I actually rushed through half of it. No guides. I just went through it, and you know, like 18 levels finished. I will show you two or three basic levels, how it works, and then I will just show you without. Making them without solving them a couple more so that you can see the growth of complexity. So let's just solve this one. The laser goes, I guess, from this dot. So we can just refract it, right? It's 90 degrees here, 90 degrees here. Typical law of refraction. And there we go. Second level. We have to do it in two steps. Refraction one, refraction two. Done. You always have to wait until it loads the oval, I mean the round object, the circle, right? Because if you don't let the laser work, then it's not gonna load it. Let's see if I do it very short, like this, see, it's gonna go down. If I go like this, it's gonna go down. If I load it, I think it's gonna stay. Right, so that was it. So this is one of the mechanics that I've found. Also, there is maybe, can I go further? Yes, I can go further. I think I can. Actually, no. It seems that I can't go further even though I did the levels before. So there seems to be a problem. It doesn't save the progress. It's very weird. Because I was actually further than this. And because there is no choice of levels, it only allows me to go to the first levels, completely first. And then we can go towards the one we did. But we can't go further, apparently. Yeah, so it has broken progression. You would need to do it in one sitting. In that case, I will maybe do a few more. Like this, and we'll see. I don't want to redo everything, just do another mechanic because there is one more mechanic I wanted to show you. So let's just go until this other mechanic, and I'm gonna stop there. I'm not gonna definitely play the game, the full game in one sitting because this makes no sense. But I want to go all the way. See, I can't even show it to you without montage, I would have to actually do it in one sitting. That's not very good, clearly. So yeah, the game is lacking in basic elements. It definitely should have the ability to save and to choose any level you want. I don't know why it's not refracting. This is very weird. I think we have to refract like this, because this one is like different. It's dark or something. Maybe it's dark and doesn't refract. And go further. Yeah, we're not gonna see it probably, because there is a little bit too far to show you this mechanic. Basically, it's a moving platform. You click it and it moves, like up or down, or left or right, and then you can kinda affect the beam in a different way. It's a platform that kinda extends in one of directions, not just turns around. But it's another mechanic that's not yet available. Is this gonna do it? Yes. So as you can see, this is very fast. I'm just going through first levels very quickly. This one, you kind of can treat it as 0 and 1 positions and write it down. Like this one is 0, 0, 0, 1. And just treat it as a binary code. So there will be 16 combinations here all together. So you could probably do it this way, if you know what I mean. That would be, I don't know, I should probably go all the way up, right? Somehow. This one should refract there, and it's gonna let us see another level. Yeah, this one definitely needs to be turned, probably this one once. I go back, and then probably one of those. Probably one of those, right? So basically, you check a couple of combinations and you should be done with it. This one will be more problematic. Yeah, probably not this one, but one of those. Then you have to use all of them, all the provided ones. So it seems hard, but it's not. However, later on there is a bigger complexity, so they will probably take more and more time to solve. Not the first ones, but at some point you will be kind of forced to do a little bit more effort. Right, this one will go there, and this one has to definitely change. And still no new mechanic. Yeah, this one is quite long. So I'm gonna, guys, I'm gonna stop here. So far I found two mechanics, this one and the one with the moving platforms, but they're a bit too far and I can't pick a level, so I'm gonna stop here. It's not very polished, I would say. I know it's minimalistic, but it definitely needs separate buttons for sound and music, unless there is just music, and I guess there is, but in that case you would need a slider, not a button. You would need to have a choice of resolution and the ability to save your progress and pick any level, or well, either pick any level from the beginning or unlock levels and then play from the point you stop, not just do the whole game in one sitting, because that's really stupid. This is below average, guys. The mechanic itself works, of course. It's well, it's just a puzzle game, so refracting a beam is not a big problem. It works correctly, but it lacks those super basic elements, especially the choice of levels. Also, resolution and sound are super basic, so this is below standard. Also, the number of levels is below standard. If you can do half the game in 15 minutes, that's definitely less than we have seen before. Some of those puzzle games had like 100 levels with more complexity and more interesting mechanics. I found only two mechanics in half of the game, so that's not much, and even that was all based on the refracting beam, nothing else. The only difference was that the other platform was moving a little bit differently, but aside from that, it was one gimmick game as we usually see. So I'm gonna just leave it with 3 points out of 10. I think it's just below average in terms of polish and choice of levels. If it was fixed, I would give it 5, but it would need to have a proper slider, a choice of resolution, and a choice of levels, and saving your progress at least. I don't think it would go further than 5 out of 10, because you would need to add multiple mechanics, probably like 100 levels, then I would be able to push it above average. So far it's definitely below average game, but it is a playable puzzle game, however very short. So if this is satisfying for you, you can definitely play it as one of the puzzle games, but you will be probably done before the refund time, so it's not a good investment. If it's super cheap, I don't know if it's cheap because it is released in 9 days. If it's super cheap, you grab it on sale, and if you are interested, I think you can grab it just to add it to your collection, but only for a very low money. So definitely less than the average, even within this genre. Okay, guys, so that was Lizer, and I gave it 3 out of 10. And that will be it for this review. I will see you guys in the next one, hopefully with a better game.